My name is Jasmine Asia. I am a model from London and I'm a gamer. I was born in London, but my family are from Bangladesh. There's so much more to gaming than people think. It's not just sitting at a computer and just typing and, like, you know, wasting your time. A lot of gaming characters inspire the way that, like, I would pose, for example, because I want to be seen as, like, strong. I like the exaggeration of video game characters. I think because they're not realistic, it's, like, good to have a break from reality. I would describe myself as, I don't know, like, passionate, quiet, and loud at the same time. If I was in a video game, I would want to be like a really cool villain, you know, like someone evil and like has like mystical powers. Villains are always better than the heroes. Yeah, I want to have my own game. Maybe like way, way, way into the future. I want to do like the motion capture where they put like the dots on you and you get put in a game basically. My virtual role model is Bayonetta. She's literally a fashion model and she's also like a witch and her fighting set is amazing. And my boyfriend showed me this game and I was like obsessed with her. She exudes like feminine like power and energy and she's still very like a boss. I feel like an alien a lot of the time. So I like to dance like an alien. Dancing is like self-expression. So I like to do like weird like movements like this.
Could you date a non-gamer?
No, because it is such a big part of like my life and all I talk about. The gaming is a huge part of our like connection. We both have our headsets on as well. We can't hear anyone else but like us. But yeah, like dating a non-gamer is so boring.
You want water?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
I get so nervous when I talk. I would play maybe, it's not that long, like maybe 4 hours a day. Okay, I think Jet's Market, honestly, like, oh my gosh. People would just say, oh, you don't look like a gamer. And there's no way to look like a gamer. You just are, you're not. I don't game because I want attention. I game because it's like, I enjoy it. I've been gaming since I was like a child and it's natural to me. I love the emotion that gaming brings out of you because it's just pixels on a screen, but it has so much like depth and layers behind it. And sometimes if you're sad, you can play like story-based games to kind of take you out of this world, be in someone else's shoes for a while and just have other responsibilities. There's this game called Valheim and it's just like a Viking world. There's really calm music. You actually chop down trees, you collect wood. And it's like a simulating of what it was like to be a Viking. I have an advantage being a woman because when you're a man, there's so many like restrictions on you, like the patriarchy as well, and like a lot of like male. When you're a female, you can go in and out of femininity or masculinity, especially when you're Asian and Asian girls are taught to be very like, we can't be out there. We can't be like too expressive. We can't like cut our hair crazy. We can't like, you know, even go out. But my parents were very liberal with me. But I see other girls suffering because of their families, of having like a family reputation. I make sure that I am my own priority and that I don't have to depend on anyone else. So I want to make sure that like the things that make me happy come first rather than like my sad feelings. I have no boundaries. I'm free. I'm happy.
Big boundary has been my own mind.